In today's video, we're going to be diving into the best email applications as we enter 2023. We're going to be diving into all of them, around 15 plus, that are the best rated on the market. We will be giving you the lowdown so you can pick the best email app for you and your work. So welcome, my name is Francesca and I'm very excited to be helping you choose your email application today. Something very important before we begin that is really fundamental when choosing one of these, and that's looking at two things, the privacy policies and the pricing, two P's. Check them out before you dive into each of them, because that's very important when finding an email application, where your data is being stored, how you like your data being stored, and that is really important. So today's video is kindly sponsored by Sanebox, and we'll find out a little bit more about them and their AI tech later in this video. You can also find out Tool Finder below with all of the email applications that we mentioned today in that application and going into much more depth. So if you want to skip this entire video, straight over to Tool Finder if you want, but do stick around because you'll find out some details that you might find helpful. So number one is Spike. Now, if you've not heard of Spike, it's like a conversational email. It's available on quite a lot of platforms actually, and it does seem pretty reliable. I have used it in the past as a trial period in my review that we did in depth here on the channel. And it's sort of like using iMessage, but for your email. So you can write conversations and send them, but it sends it all in the right format, just in much more of a relaxed style, which is nice. And if you have or are communicating with someone who is using Spike, you can also interact with a lot more multimedia, like documents and things like that. So Spike is growing in popularity. It's always being featured by Apple these days. Worth checking out if you want a much more fluid email, especially for you and your team. Talking about solid team email applications, number two is Missive. Now, this one I used for roughly 3 years. And to be honest, if I was looking to get a virtual assistant or an assistant of any kind, this is a great email application for that because you can resolve stuff in email and pass it on to other people in a team without leaving too much of the stress of the inbox externally. So you can, for example, use and invite people to them, and then you can allocate or assign stuff to people using comments and go into much more depth with the team abilities than you can in some other email applications. So Missive is also super customizable. I've never seen the settings area as customizable to edit the appearance, how notifications land, and much, much more. It's a really gorgeous looking email experience, and to be honest, a very reliable one from the years that I used it in. Number three is Spark Mail. They recently had a release at the start of the year. It sort of went a bit haywire, a lot of miscommunication at the start, but they have definitely solved all of that. But Spark Mail is probably one that I recommend as the most all-rounder email experience, just because it has a really relaxed nature. It has some great smart inbox abilities to help that overwhelm when you're inside of your inbox, but also has the nature of a classic inbox to help you to manage them. So it's got some good smart functionality with productivity focus, but also some traditional structure to your email account. And this is one that really does get a lot of people raving about it. They've really boosted up their premium experience as well for those who are more interested in that. Number four is Edison Mail. Again, one that crops up a lot when you find these listicles, but it is a much more Android-focused, mobile-focused experience that has sort of bells and whistles that people like, much more simplified than the ones we've just talked about, but at the same time, presents a good email experience for those who are looking to do it on the mobile experience. Numero cinque. Number five is Proton Mail. And Proton Mail is probably the experience that a lot of people go to for the security aspects. Proton, the company, are one that focus very much on securing information and making sure that is all safe and secure. Based in Switzerland, I believe their servers are. And it's something that a lot of people tend to go to for that experience. I actually saw it in Sound of Metal, an Amazon film recently, with a guy emailing on Proton Mail. It's so weird to see. And I know a couple of people use it that are very security centric and want to make sure that companies that they don't necessarily like Google, etc., don't like their email being touched, and it's quite a nice one because you get your own domain name when you start up your account. So time to talk a little bit about Sanebox. For those who don't know, Sanebox can be plugged into any of the email apps we use today and we're talking about today. And what it does is it uses AI technology to basically filter your email to make sure you focus on the quality email versus the quantity. So it helps to process your email. You can train it as well, and basically gets a better output when you're trying to focus on the most important things. If you're interested in checking out Sanebox, you can find it in the link in the description. So number six is a gorgeous email experience. Probably one that when I was looking at Missive, I was like, oh, Polymail, number six, Polymail is beautiful. Looks great, works very well, but it doesn't necessarily have as good of a general reputation. It's not really widely known as a popular email application. But if you're looking for something that's between Spark Mail and Missive, and you don't want the complexity of the amount of settings and detail as Missive has, but you want a beautiful email experience like Spark, then this is a good middle ground for you. And it does have some good team abilities to get started with as well. Worth taking a look at, but definitely not one that really I know too many people that use it, if that makes sense. Number seven, another one you can get with a domain name, hey.com, grew hugely in popularity as it's developed by the folks over at Basecamp. And Hey is a gorgeous email application again, but it goes in a little bit of a different fashion. It has its own productivity system behind it. It's something you need to learn. Something called an inbox in it. Inbox, not inbox. And what's cool about it is it has its own system of learning around how you work. So for example, emails come in, but they are landing in this space where you need to check them off, whether they actually come into your inbox, and then it processes them into different areas, which is pretty neat. So Hey, a great one for those who are very productivity centric, fairly reasonable at $99 a year. And I say that because you get a free domain, and you also get a good quality email experience on pretty much all devices. And when you look at some of the other ones like Superhuman, they get expensive during the year. A good personal to email experience, Hey. I used it for about a year and I found it pretty decent. Next up, number eight is Newton Mail. I used to work at Newton Mail, fun fact, and they've had a lot of different owners over the last couple of years. It's sort of like a very strange one because it keeps resurrecting itself. But Newton Mail presents a very clean looking experience with a few Zen focused abilities on calming down your inbox. But what's most important about it is it presents a reliable way to handle emails. And I've found it really reliable in the past. And that's not just me working in their marketing department, but basically they have it available on a lot of devices, but it ran pretty smoothly when we had that all set up. So Newton Mail's a nice one, and it's very nice looking. Great logo, great design, and some great niche features. And a fairly reasonably priced, think it's still $49.99, but obviously you can check over at Toolfinder. So number nine is one that I currently use right now. It's Superhuman. This is the one that everyone talks about as the biggest email experience. It's $30 a month, so it's quite expensive. So this is for somebody who's being very serious with their emails in terms of they see a high output of value when it comes to their workload. Maybe you are a somebody that is in the department that spends a lot of time in email. I would probably only recommend Superhuman to those who spend more than 2 hours in email, and they're directly correlating email output to results, if that makes sense. Just because it's quite a high price and it's important to value that price against what you're doing with your work. So worth checking out Superhuman if you're interested. Okay, next up, number 10 is Thunderbird. This is a free email application. You only have to donate on their website if you do want to pay in some form. But basically this is available on a lot of different devices, Mac, and many more, Windows, desktop, but it's an open source project. So it's very much coming from a privacy aspect as well, but it's not the nicest looking, but it definitely has some neat functionalities that some people like in the community. I always find that a lot of people type in Thunderbird in the comments, you miss that one out. and it's well worth putting in this video. Number 11 is Front. And again, this one is very much team-centric, but in a very different fashion. This one helps you to allocate and assign certain tasks that come into people. So for example, if somebody emails in from support and you want to delegate this into your team, this is a neat one for that. So if you're looking for a team email that can handle lots of things coming in and being able to assign things to certain people in your department, this is a neat one for you. So number 12 is Mailbird. And a lot of people regard this as one of the best desktop experience for Windows emailing. And a lot of people like Mailbird and find it to be a really reliable experience. It has fairly reasonable pricing, but for businesses, it does have a separate pricing as well, where you can integrate it with other popular tools. Well worth looking at. Number 13 is Airmail. This was an iOS and Mac application that won a lot of awards a couple of years ago, probably around 2016. And to be honest, it is a nice application, but it's definitely not anything to write home about now. It's got a good design, a good functionality, but when it comes to some of the cutting edge designs that we've mentioned here with the likes of Hey, Spark Mail, Spike, Missive, and many more like that, it doesn't really compare because it's sort of a snapshot in time as a good quality design, but probably hasn't really changed much since 2016. But a good, reliable application if you want to check it out. Number 14 is Outlook. Now, Outlook has really advanced in the last couple of years. Microsoft Outlook has provided some better features, including boards, improved calendar experience. They actually bought a popular calendar application called Sunrise, integrated it into the experience, and they continue to innovate in that department. Microsoft Outlook have improved it by introducing Outlook One and many more experiences, and this is a good one if you're looking for something that bolts onto a really nice calendar layout and experience on the sides. So next up is Canary Mail, and one that I actually recently only discovered. I had heard of it in the past, but they recently got a lot of development and funding from Sequoia, and essentially they're trying to be the AI email company by helping you to have an AI assistant inside of your inbox, helping to provide you with recommendations and things to improve prioritization. So this application is a really interesting one and seems to be growing a lot in the market, despite its seemingly very old nature in what it's been doing in the past. So number 16, Rooftop. This is one again that I heard about more recently, but is similar to Front in a fashion, a shared inbox for helping to communicate as a team collective. A lot of people like it as an alternative to Polymail or Front, and helps you to manage you and your team's inbox in one location. Now, finally, number 17 is an app that I absolutely loved and used, and actually you can still use it now. It's in an open source experience, so you can download the latest version of Tempo, although they do not run it still, so that's something to note. They don't run updates and things like that. They are now shut down. You can still download it and still activate it with your account, and it is gorgeous. But remember, naturally, it is no longer continued. It's discontinued. I love that application so much, but it's great to see it still available for those who want to download it and play with it in their experience, especially developers too. So thank you very much, folks, for stopping by and checking out all these email applications. Again, check out Tool Finder, and a big, big thank you to Sanebox for sponsoring today's feature. So make sure to check out those folks in the description below. Thank you very much, folks. Make sure to subscribe to keep productive, and I'll see you all very, very soon. Cheerio.